The RCMP is now enforcing COVID-19 quarantine orders. Last week, the RCMP revealed Public Health Canada requested that they make sure anyone arriving in Canada did quarantine themselves. Now, that means Canadians who refuse to follow the rules after coming home or coming to this country could get a visit from the Mounties. And those who disobey could face fines of up to $750,000 and up to 6 months in prison. Let's bring in Commissioner Brenda Luckey of the RCMP. She joins us now from Ottawa. Thanks for joining us, Commissioner.
Thanks for having me.
So when were you asked to do this, and have you had to carry that rollout so far to this point?
Yeah, it was early last week we were asked through public health, the public health agency. And essentially what happens is the Canadian Border Services takes the names, they give them to the public health, and then all the names come to us and we distribute them to the police of jurisdiction, including RCMP areas. And these are people that the healthcare have already probably contacted via phone or email or text. And sometimes they may require a physical verification of the quarantine.
Okay. Any idea of how many of those have been carried out, a knock on the door?
To date, there has been approximately 94 names that have gone, around 90 names that have gone to law enforcement. And as far as enforcement goes, there has been no actual, there have been verifications, but I can't say the exact number.
Okay, so sounds like most people are following the quarantine order and are at home and quarantining themselves. But remind us again what happens if they're not there. Do they get a couple of visits, or if they're not at home at that first visit, do the RCMP wait for them? I mean, how does that get carried out?
Now, our enforcement obviously is going to be based on three, like education, encouragement, and obviously empathy, because everybody has a different situation. So to be putting people in jail is not going to be our initial response. It's basically calling the people, ensuring they're there, making visual contact, and ensuring that they're following the quarantine. And to date, people are following the quarantine.
Because clearly this fine is quite stiff. Even if they don't get jail time, they could end up paying a hefty, hefty fine.
Absolutely. And it's because it's to show people we take this very seriously. It's important that people follow the rules, take the advice from the experts in the health, and definitely self-isolate or quarantine as necessary.
So you said so far, I believe, that nobody has been fined or yet thrown in jail.
Not to my knowledge, not in RCMP jurisdiction.
Okay. And this will go on, I guess, indefinitely with the RCMP involvement?
Yes, we are the coordination for all police agencies. So we will get the names, we'll pass them on to the police of jurisdiction, and we'll do the necessary checks.
Do you anticipate doing other duties as this time goes on with maybe social distancing and that kind of thing?
Well, there's all kinds of resources that provinces can use for those kinds of activities. I know in some provinces, they're using their conservation officers, they're using their bylaw officers, they're using various provincial resources that they have. We still have, of course, our responses to frontline activities and law enforcement. So that's our primary mandate, is obviously to keep all Canadians safe.
And can you compare this time, Commissioner, to any other that you've been through in your career?
No, when we have a massive response to anything, whether it's a forest fire like Fort McMurray or floods in southern Alberta, it takes a good coordinated response. And I'm just honestly, I have to say how amazed and impressed I am with the government's response, both provincially and federally, and how everybody's working together to ensure that we're having a great response to this. And I think our response has been second to none, actually.
Well, Commissioner, thank you for joining us today. Appreciate that. Keep up the good work.
Thank you so much. And I really just want to say thank you to all the frontline workers, especially I'm going to be a little bit biased to the RCMP and all the people that support law enforcement. So thank you very much for having me.
Have a good morning.
You too.